Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from Dimensions Guntur. To discuss the explanation of content, which is the question. Okay, let us discuss the first question, which was the 51st question. This is given that, what is the value of M and N respectively? If a number is given, M 390484 58N, M 390484 58N is divisible by 8 and 11. This is the number which is divisible by both 8 and 11, and we need to find out the values of M and N, where M and N are mentioned as single digit integers. Since this number is divisible by 8 and 11, we need to check the divisibility rules of 8 as well as the 11. So what is the divisibility rule of 8? A number is divisible by 8 if its last 3 digits are divisible by 8. So to check or to find the value of N, we need to apply the divisibility rule of 8 anamata. That means concentrate on the last 3 digits. These last 3 digits are divisible by 8. Okay? And we know 8 sevens is 56. We're left with 2. So 2 and then we have N. So 8 threes is 24. Since we have 2, if this N is 4, then automatically this number is divisible by 8. So the value of N is equals to 4. So the value of N is 4. So we can replace N with 4. To find the value of M, we need to check the divisibility rule of 11. What is the divisibility rule of 11? The sum of digits in the even places minus the sum of digits in the odd places is divisible by 11. So for that, you need to concentrate on the difference between the sum of digits in even places to the sum of digits in odd places. Now the number is M 390484 584, because N is 4. Okay. Now find the sum of these values. 4 plus 5 is 9. Okay. 9 plus 8 is 17. Plus 0 is 17. Plus 3 is 20. So sum of these values is 20. Minus, we need to find out other sum. Okay. What it is? 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. 16 plus 9 is 25. 25 plus M is 25 plus M. 20 minus 25 plus M must be multiple of 11. 11 of something. Okay. This is some multiple of 11. We need to find out the value of M. Okay. So if M is 6, 25 plus 6 is 31. The difference is 11. It is a multiple of 11. So the value of M is 6. Okay. The value of N is 4 as well as the value of M is 6. And finally, your answer is option C. Okay. So there we applied the divisibility rules of 8 as well as the divisibility rule of 11. Right. And the next one is what? 52nd problem. They asked us to find out the highest power of 9 in 99 factorial. We need to find out the highest power of 9 in 99 factorial. Okay? I think you are all aware that 99 factorial is nothing but product of the first 99 natural numbers. That means 99 into 98 into and so on into 2 into 1. This product is represented as 99 factorial. Okay. If you prime factorize this product can be expressed as some 2 power something into 3 power something into like that. Okay. After expressing this, we need to find out the 9 power. Okay. 9 power something has happened in this product. We need to find out that 9 power. Okay. See. So, how can we find out the 9 power something? Highest power of 9 in this 99 fact. There is a logic that to find out the highest power of the prime P, okay, if P is a prime, to find out the highest power of P in N factorial, highest power of P in N factorial can be calculated using the logic that N by P, okay, this represents the integral value of the division N by P plus N by P square, okay, the integral part of N by P square plus and so on, like N by P cube, N by P power 4, like that, okay. See, since 9 is not prime, okay, we need to concentrate on 3 power. So we need to find out the highest power of 3 in the 99 factorial first. So to find out the highest power of 3 in 99 factorial, the result is the integral part of 99 by 3 plus the integral part of 99 by 3 square plus the integral part of 99 by 3 cube plus the integral part of 99 by 3 power 4 plus the integral part of 99 by 3 power 5, like that. See, if you observe here, 3 power power 5 is more than 99. So its integral part will be 0. From there we can neglect all the values. Now this is 99 by 3, which is nothing but 33. 99 by 9, nothing but 11. 99 by 27. 99 by 27 means 27. 3 is 81. So this value is 3 point something. So its integral part contains 3. And then 99 by 81. 99 by 344. 99 by 81 means 1 point something. Its integral part is 1. Okay. If you add 33 plus 11, which is nothing but 1. 44 plus 4 is 48. So in this prime factorization, we have 3 power 5. Find out the power of 3. So totally we have 3 power 48. This 3 power 48 can be expressed as 3 square power 24, nothing but 9 power 24. So the highest power of 9 in 99 factorial is 24, and your answer is 24. Right? There ends the problem. Okay? So memorize it, that the highest power of a prime in the n factorial can be calculated by using this formula. To apply this formula, the p must be prime. Okay? Right. The next one is 53rd problem. What is 53rd problem? See, it is given that find k for which the system of equation has infinitely many solutions. The given system of equations are 3x minus y is equals to 4, kx plus y is equals to 3. The system of these two equations have infinitely many solutions. Okay, two equations will give us infinitely many solutions if these two equations are what do you call it? Dependent on the other. That means if two equations represent the same equation. What I mean, if you have an equation like 2x plus 3y is equals to 5, then any other equation, okay, something like 6x plus 9y is equals to 15. These type of equations represents these two, it appears like two different equations, but if you observe, these two are same equations, okay. By multiplying 3, this equation, you get this equation. That means they appear like different equations, but actually they are a unique equation. A unique equation in two variables will give us infinitely many solutions. That means two equations will give us infinitely many solutions if these two are like this. If the equations are like this, the coefficients 2 by 6, 3 by 9, 5 by 15 are same. The ratio will be the coefficients. So here the ratio is 3 by k. Here the ratio is minus 1 by 1. Here the ratio is 4 by 2. This ratio is not equal actually. Since this ratio is not equal, we can't find the value of k such that the given system has infinitely many solutions. Okay, your answer is none. Okay, there are no problems. The next one is 54th. For this 54th problem, the average of 11 students is given as 50. If the average of first 6 students is 49 and that of the last 6 students is 52, find the sixth student is the question. Okay, so the sixth student is the middle one. Okay, the sixth student is involved in the first average of first six, as well as the sixth student is involved in the average of last six also. So your answer is, first of all, you need to add the sum of the values of the first six students. Okay, average is given as 49, so sum of the values of the first six is 6 into 49, and the average of the last six is calculated by 6 into 52, where the middle observation, which is the sixth observation, appears twice. Okay? Right. You need to subtract that one, which gives us the total sum of the values. There are total 11 people into 50. Okay? If you simplify, you will get the value of x. And that value of x will be 56. And the sixth observation is 56. There it is. Next one is 55th problem. For this 55th problem, by selling 33 meters of cloth, a man gains sale price of 11 meters, and they ask us to calculate the gain percent. Okay, a man gains sale price of 11 meters. They ask us to calculate gain percent. Gain percent is nothing but what gain by profit into 100. No, gain by CP into 100 will give us the gain percent. What is the gain here? Selling price of 11 meters is the gain. But what is the cost? By costing, by selling 33 meters, you will gain that one. So selling price of 11 meters by cost price of 33 meters into 100. Since it is selling price, we can express it also selling price. Okay. So selling price of 11 meters divided by selling price of 33 is nothing but selling price of 22 here. Actually, profit is equals to what? SP minus CP. Okay. Profit on 33 meters is equals to, profit on 33 meters is nothing but what? Selling price of 11. selling price of 11 is equals to selling price of 33 minus cost price of 33. So cost price of 33 is nothing but selling price of 22. So selling price of 11 divided by selling price of 22 into 100. Okay, selling price and selling price, this is twice, and then 100 by 2 is 50%. Okay, observe it carefully. Actually, the gain is given in terms of selling price, which is selling price of 11 meters. Okay, when you will get that gain? By selling 33 meters, so divided by the cost price of 33 meters. But the numerator is in terms of selling price, the denominator is in terms of cost price. We need to convert the denominator of cost price also into selling price by using this logic, where it is equals to selling price of 22 meters, and on simplification you will get the profit is 50%. Okay, next one is 56th problem. What is that 56th problem? Find the single discount equivalent to two successive discounts of 15% and 20%. Okay, the two discounts are given as what? 15% and 20%. We need to find out the single equivalent discount of those two. The direct logic is minus x minus y plus x into y. That means 15 into 20 is nothing but 300 by 100, which is nothing but minus 35 plus 3, 32% is the what? Thus, equivalent discount of the two given discounts. Next one is 57th one. Okay, 60,000 amounts to 68,694 in 2 years. Then find the rate of interest. Okay, a direct question which is given that amount is 68,694 on depositing 60,000. Okay, but we are going to calculate the rate of interest for 2 years divided by two, powers two. Okay, we need to simplify. First of all, you just divide with the six. Okay, six ones, six fours, okay, 24 and the 29, and then six fours, and then six nines, 11449, and that was 10,000. 11449 is nothing but 107 square, okay, this is equals to 100 square into 1 plus r by 100 whole square. Remove the square and then send this 100 this side, and on simplification you will get the rate of interest as 7%, okay, a direct problem from the compound interest. Next one is the 58th problem. For this 58th problem is also direct problem. Okay, they asked us to calculate the interest paid on the loan of 6,000 at 5% per year for 5 years. Use directly the simple interest formula and you will get your answer as 1500. That is the problem. Okay, and the next one is 59th problem. For this 59th problem, A and B can do a piece of work in 18 days. A and B can do a piece of work in 18 days. So in 1 day, both together can do 1 by 18th part of the work. This is 1 day capacity of the both A and B. In the same manner, in 1 day, B plus C can do 1 by 12th part of the work. As well as in 1 day, C and A together can do 1 by 24th part of the work. This is the 1 day works of AB, BC and as well as CA. If you add all those things, you will get the twice of A plus B plus C is 1 by 18 plus 1 by 24 plus 1 by 12. Okay. But the LCM of 18, 12 and 24 will be what? 72. Right? 18, 4 is 72. 12, 6 is 72. 24, 3 is 72. And then 4 plus 6 plus 3 is 13 by 72. From this, you will get that 1 day work of A plus B plus C is nothing but 13 by 144. This 13, A, B and C, 3% together will complete 13 by 144th part of the work in 1 day, as per the problem. But they asked us to calculate the how long would each take separately to do it. Since A plus B plus C can do in 13 by 44 days, then 1 day work of A is nothing but this 13 by 144 minus the part of B plus C. That means 13 by 144 minus 1 by 12. 1 by 12 is nothing but 12 by 144, which is nothing but 1 by 144. So, in 1 day, A will complete 1 by 144th part of the work. So, he takes 144 days to complete the work. So, first value must be 144. Among the options, it will be option A or option C. Then, in the same manner, you can find the values of other persons B and C. Your option is option A. There is the problem, right? So, this is the problem from the time and work. And the next one is the 60th problem. From the time distance, it is given that a boy walking at 3 by 5 of his usual speed reaches his school by 14 minutes late. Find his usual time to reach the school is the question. Okay, first of all, let the usual speed is S and the usual time taken to reach the school is T. So the distance is ST. In the second case, the speed will be 3 by 5 of s, whereas the time is the 14 minutes late. So take it as some t plus 4t. Okay. We need to find the usual time to reach the speed. Okay. So we need to find the t value, the distance in both the cases. So in the first case, the distance is s into t. In the second case, the distance is speed. We calculate s, will get cancelled. So which is nothing but 1. Pi t is equals to, pi t is equals to 3 plus 14, this is 42, 2t, and t is equals to 21 minutes. The usual time is 21 minutes. Okay. And the next one is the 61st problem. What it is given? That takes some point. Walk from t to t. X walks at 3 kilometers per hour and X and Y walks at 3 kilometers per hour and the speed of X is 3 kilometers per hour. So they ask to find the radius of the circle D is 1 3 by 4 meters. Radius of 1 3 by 4 meters, 4 plus 3, 7 by 4 meters. Radius is 7 by 4 meters. How many revolutions will it make in traveling 11 kilometers? In one revolution, okay, the distance covered the circle is the circumference, which is 2 by r. 2 into 2 by 7 into r is 7 by 4. 7 is 7 by 4. So take a 1, 2, number 4 will get cancelled, which is 11. But the question is, how many revolutions are required to cover 11 kilometers? They mentioned that in how many ways 5 prizes be given away to 4 boys when each boy is eligible for all the prizes. Each boy is eligible for all the prizes, okay? So in okay person, okay boy ki I can give all the prizes, or I can give one for first boy, second for second boy, third for third boy, or I can give 2 prizes for the second boy. And we have different options here, okay? So we need to calculate the total number of chances. For example, if we select the first boy, for the first boy, we can give any of the 5 prizes. So there are 5 chances for the first boy to get the prizes. Okay, there are 5 chances for the first boy to get the prizes. In the same way for the second boy, for the third boy, and as well as for the fourth boy. So the total number of chances to distribute those prizes for these 4 boys is nothing but 5 into 5 into 5, so which is nothing but 5 power 4. Okay, so there is the problem. And the next one is 65th problem. 65th problem is a problem from trigonometry. Okay, for this problem it is given that 1 plus tan 32 into 1 plus tan 13 degrees, okay, divided by 1 plus tan 23 degrees into 1 plus tan 22 degrees. We need to calculate this one. Actually, in trigonometry, we have a logic. What is that one? If A plus B is equals to 45 degrees, if A plus B is equals to 45 degrees, then by taking tan on both sides and on simplification, you will get that 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B is equals to 2. This is the logic we can call it. A plus B is 45, 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B is 2. So if you observe, for the numerator 32 plus 13 is 48, so this value is 2. And the denominator 23 plus 22 is also 45, this value is also 2. 2 by 2 is equals to 1, and your answer is 1. Then ends the problem. Okay? Right. And then 66th problem. For this 66th problem, the diameter of the circumcircle of the triangle whose sides are 61, 60 and 11. Okay, they ask us to calculate the circumcenter. Okay, these are the sides of the triangle. So first of all, to decide the type of the triangle, square it. Okay, 61 square and then 60 square and then 11 square. 60 square is 3600, whereas 11 square is 121. So 61 square is 3721. Find it, 61 square. Now if you observe, sum of these two is equals to the 61 square. Sum of these two is equals to 61 square means then the Pythagorean result, we have a triangle, if this is 11 and if this is 60, this is 61. These three sides will make a right angle triangle like this. So for any right angle triangle, circum radius is the half of this distance. This is the circum radius. But they ask us to calculate circum diameter, total length we need to consider. 61 is the circum diameter of the triangle. Okay. So in a right angle triangle, circum diameter is nothing but the length of the hypotenuse. You need to memorize it and then your answer is 61. Then for the 67th problem, a direct question. Actually, there involved two similar triangles whose sides are in the ratio 2 is to 5. If sides are in the ratio 2 is to 5, automatically areas in the ratio of the squares of the sides. So the ratio between the areas is 4 is to 25. There ends the problem. Okay. And the next one is 68th problem. For the 68th problem, what they given? Angle between the two radii of the circle is 130 degrees. For example, if you have a circle, this is a center, okay, draw two radii from the center. They mentioned that the angle between these two radius is 130 degrees. And the angle between the tangents at the end of the radii, okay, at the end of this radii, draw a tangent. At the end of this radii, draw another tangent, okay. And we know that the tangent and radii are perpendicular. This is also perpendicular. So, and they asked us to calculate the angle between these two tangents. That means this angle. 90 plus 90 is 180. So, this is 130. So, surely it is 50. So, your answer is 50 because sum of these four angles must be 360 degrees. Okay? So, your answer is 50 degrees. That is the problem. Right? And the next one is 19th problem, which is the 69th problem. For the 69th problem, two solid right circular cones of same height, the radii of their bases are R1 and R2. These cones are melted and recast into a cylinder of the same height. The base radius of the cylinder we need to find. First of all, two cones are melted to form a cylinder. That means the volume of first cone is equal to volume of first cone plus volume of second cone is equal to volume of cylinder. What is the volume of first cone? 1 by 3 pi R1 square H. And volume of the second cone? 1 by 3 pi R2 square H. Both have the same height. Okay, these two are melted and then recasted to form a cone, a cylinder, whose volume is pi, radius we don't know, R square, height is same, H. Okay, among all those values, just cancel out pi H, pi H, pi H. Okay, then which is nothing but R1 square plus R2 square by 3 is equals to capital R square. And they asked us to calculate capital R, which is root of this value, and your answer is option B. There ends the problem. Okay, and then after the 69th one, we have 70th problem. What is the 70th one? If the angle of elevation of the ladder leaning against a wall is 60 degrees, this is the wall, okay, whereas this is the ladder, okay, then the angle of elevation of this is given as 60 degrees. So surely the wall is perpendicular to the floor, right? And the foot of the ladder is 9.5 meters away from the wall. So foot of the ladder is this one, which is away from the wall at a distance of 9.5 meters. Okay, and they asked us to calculate the length of the ladder. This is the ladder, and we need to calculate the length of the ladder. So these two sides are involved. Okay, you need to apply cos 60 degrees, adjacent side and hypotenuse. So clearly it is cos 60 degrees is equals to 9.5 by L. But what is actually cos 60? Cos 60 is nothing but 1 by 2. So L is nothing but 9.52, which is 18 plus 1, 19 meters is the length of the ladder. Okay, there ends the problem. And the next one, from 71 to 75, we need to answer by using the given two pi diagrams. The two pi diagrams represents the what? Percentage of six different types of garments in store one, as well as percentage of six different types of garments in store two. Actually, in store one, totally there are how many garments? 12,600. Whereas in store two, the total number of garments are 14,500. Individual percentages of the types of garments is given from A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay? And your questions. 71st one. The total number of D and A type garments in store one. So D type garments is 19%, A type garments is 16%. 19 plus 16% of the total number of garments, 12,600. We need to calculate this value. This value is equals to the approximately equal to the double the number of which type of garments in store two is the question. Okay. Among the options, for each type of garment, we need to calculate the store two number of garments, okay? So almost equal value select jails into the, and your answer is option B, okay? Right. This is 71st problem. And the next one is 72nd one. What is the total number of C type garments in both the stores together? C type garments. In store one, C type garments are 8%. So 8% of 12,600 is nothing but 8 into 126. Plus in store two, okay? C type garments are 18%. So 18% of 14,500 is nothing but 18 into 145. If we add these two, you will get the total number of garments of C type. Okay, that was your answer, nothing but 3610. And the next one is 73rd problem. The difference in the number of which type of garments in two stores is maximum. Okay, among the options for each type of garment, you need to find the number of garments in store one and the number of garments in store two. At the end, take the difference between those two values. Okay, the maximum difference garments you need to select, and your answer is option D. Your answer is garments type C and then option D. Okay. The next one is 74th one. The number of D type garments in store 1 is more than that in store 2 by what percentage? Okay. 74th one. The number of D type garments in store 1. D type garments in store 1 are is more than that in store 2. If you calculate D type garments in store 1, you will get it as 2016. Okay. More than that in store 2. Then D type garments in store 2. If you calculate D type garments in store 2, 12% of the 14,500, which is 1740. Okay, the difference is nothing but 276. Okay, we need to compare this 276 with the store 2 anamata. So 276 divided by 1740 into 100 we need to calculate, and that is your answer. Okay, and the next one is 75. The number of E-type garments in store 1. E-type garments in store 1. E-type garments in store 1 are 11%. So 11 into 126 is the value, which is 1386. Then is approximately what percent of the B-type garments in store 2? B-type garments in store 2, the percentage is 14%. So 14 into 145, which is nothing but what? 2030 is the B-type garments in store 2. They asked us to calculate by how much this B2 is more than E1. Okay, the difference is compared with 1386. Okay, no. The question is, the number of E-type garments in store 1 is approximately what percent of the number of B-type garments in store 2. So we need to calculate 1386 is how much percent of 2030. That means 1386 divided by 2030 into 100 you need to calculate. If you calculate, and you will get the answer as 68%. Okay. So finally, this is the explanation for the quantitative questions from the CGL 34th paper. Thank you. Thank you very much.